Wanda is considered one of the most passionate and positive people you'll ever meet, both personally and professionally. Her inspirational mentoring, sales, and customer service training has dubbed her to be Wanda D. Hollis, the Motivational Queen. She launched Wanda D TV, a revolutionary online real estate talk show where local businesses and community leaders discuss their services, issues, and concerns. Wanda is passionate about helping people achieve their goals and dreams. She has gone on to pursue many passions, including her I Am Enough talk show, having a seat on the West Georgia Board of Realtors, author of inspirational and motivational books, and also a strong supporter of several nonprofit organizations within her community. Wanda believes that there's no such thing as bad decisions, only regrets of not making the right attempt. For speaking engagements or to book her for your next event or conference, please visit www.IamEnough365.com.
Yo, yo, yo. It's me, Wanda D, the motivational queen. Y'all all supposed to say that at the same time. Y'all know that.
I leave that for the ladies part. I let them say that.
I know you did it. Thank you. Guys, welcome to the I Am Enough talk show. And here beside me is my lovely co-host and chef. They're going to introduce themselves in a minute, but I just want to tell y'all to thank you. Come on in. Come on in the room. Wherever you're watching from, check this out. If you're on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, LinkedIn, Snapchat. Are we on Snapchat? Well, anyway, we should be. If we're not on Snapchat, we should be. So all of that stuff, just tell them that it's time to come on in the room. This is the I Am Enough talk show where your dreams matter. We are a manifesting show. We believe that once we set intentions, that all we got to do is just expect and receive. Amen.
Amen.
It is Sunday, so can I get a amen? All right, right now. That's right. So, Chimia, what's going on?
Hello, everyone. I am Author Chimia Hill-Burton, and you know it's Freestyle Sunday.
It is Freestyle Sunday.
I wish we had that like remix.
Okay, yeah, it is Freestyle Sunday. So, what you got going on, girl? Tell them what you got brewing.
I got a couple of things brewing. So, if you haven't been following my Facebook page, you should
follow.
Author Chimia Hill-Burton. Yes.
Share,
like, comment. I love it all. Send the hearts. We love it. We'll be doing the book launch. Yes. I'll be doing a live book launch.
Live. All the way live.
Yes.
Stop.
It's all the way live.
For the third book of my trilogy, Beautiful and Hero. Beautiful and Hero, The Infringed Heart.
Wow.
So that's April the 5th at 7 p.m. on the I Am Not Talk Show. It's going to be live.
It's going to be lit. I love it.
Always.
Because you got people coming in from...
Oh, man, I got people coming in from all walks of life. I got people who read the script, didn't read the script, read the book, own the book, love the book. Don't love the book.
yeah.
Well, you can't please everybody.
You no, can, you can't.
Don't even try.
Yeah. And I don't.
Sure don't. Whew, Jesus, if you try. That's right.
Chef Antonio L. Smith.
What's happening?
What up, though? Yeah, we got Detroit in the house. Detroit,
well,
Michigan, Flint. Okay,
Flint.
We ain't going to mess with the Flintstones. We ain't going to mess with the Flintstones.
I love Detroit.
All right. We're not going to mess. I know. That was me. I slipped. Forgive me. But we still like this.
Yeah, we still Wonder Twins.
Okay, right.
Bam.
Wonder Twins.
Activate.
That's right. So, y'all, you know what? Come on in. They need to get on here into the studio. And we got a live studio audience. I'm just waiting for them to make a lot of noise.
Thank you.
Well, we got one person who has some drinks and didn't bring down for the rest of the audience.
So
talking about that rum punch, but ain't sharing with nobody.
Yeah,
so he might get caught off with an appetite.
Well, you know what? You got the food, so you know maybe he won't get a play today.
Well, you know I can't do him like that. You know,
I'm not that mean.
So you know I had to go ahead and hook him up so that way he can hire me for his event or something.
Well, and that's the whole point. That's
have a lady he want to impress. You know, and
Yeah.
And by the time I leave, he'll have a wonderful evening.
A happy ending.
A happy ending.
That's right. That's right.
Ending.
That's right.
you know, and happy that's what we do.
So what you got on the menu brewing today?
Oh, man. Today is on the menu one of my favorite appetizers I like to do, real nice little. You know, I've been on a health kick for the last month or so, trying to be at least. So today we're going to have a crusty baguette with marinated mozzarella balls, herb mozzarella balls, which consists of fresh rosemary, thyme, and basil. Okay. Which I brought some of that so they can see how do I put it together. And so then we're going to have sun-dried temesta, pesto with a prosciutto.
Okay, awesome. So nice, this is like our little appetizer.
Yeah,
and then we're going to follow you home for the main course. Is exactly. that what we're doing?
I'm the main, you know, the course, so we can go to there.
Hey, y'all better cut it out. Cut it out. Freestyle Sunday.
That's how it goes. It's real nice little meal. You know, something real nice. Mm-hmm. So the mozzarella balls are marinating in olive oil.
How long they have to marinate, Chef?
Well, I like to marinate, let them marinate for a couple of days.
Ooh.
You know, so it really soaks in the flavor. Got a little salt and pepper and, like I said, the fresh herbs, rosemary, thyme, basil. Smells real good over there.
I know it does. It does. I can't wait to...
Then you got the fresh sun-dried tomato pesto.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to be real sexy.
So what kind of, you know, I'm jumping all into your session, but I just want to know for the people might want to know. Do the people want to know?
People want to know.
Okay. So
inquiring minds always want to know.
So, the inquiring minds.
So what type of appetizer would that go good with, like with a main course?
With the main course, it can go pretty much with anything. Absolutely. Really. Mm-hmm. It can also go well with the white wine.
Mm-hmm.
So if you just want to serve this with a white wine, a nice little finger food for it, it'll go well with that.
Mm-hmm.
But you can serve it with a pasta, since it's pretty much an Italian dish appetizer anyway,
mm-hmm.
Because it's mozzarella balls.
Okay.
It's cheese. So it'll go good with an Italian dish, mainly.
Okay. Well, stop right there, because, you know, when you get in that kitchen, I'll be in that kitchen with you, and I have to find some conversation. So just don't, you know, we can't leave all that conversation.
We got some conversation today.
You know, okay, so what y'all think about this voting thing? Is everybody registered to vote? Who votes? Because I know some people don't vote. Everybody vote. Well, maybe not everybody, because everybody didn't raise their hand. So it's okay. But what's your take on that?
Which idiot do I want to vote for?
Yeah. Well, you know,
I'm
you got to choose
keep it real
one.
100.
Okay.
And, you know, to me, they're all trying to buy the black vote. Each and every last one of them. They don't care about us. All of a sudden, you see a commercial with, oh, Michael Bloomberg. He's done this for the black community. Well, he was the first one that put the stop and frisk rule in New York, arresting all the black and brown people.
Mm-hmm.
Joe Biden, he might get a pass, but I don't agree with Bernie Sanders. Bernie Sanders.
He canceled Donald Mac or McDonald's. No,
I don't agree with
Ronald McDonald's.
Rest in peace, Bernie. Rest in peace. He's rolling in his grave somewhere.
This what's the dictator name? Castro. He's okay. been
educate him, Chef.
He's been preaching about how he led a dictatorship about reading and stuff like that, which. Well, he does. He just wanted them to learn how to read so they can read his dictatorship policies that he had in Cuba.
Mm.
It was still a dictatorship.
Mm.
I don't believe in anything he says.
Right.
Pete Buttigieg.
Well, politician is tricky. Politicians are tricky.
They're all a bunch of crooked son of guns.
Yeah.
Keep it clean on that one. They're a bunch of crooked son of guns. And like I said, everybody is bucking for the black vote.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't really care about us. At the end of the day, they're going to be like, oh, okay, we got the black vote. All right, everybody want to, because our vote really does matter. If we get out there and turn out in turns, they can't stop us, which we really need to understand that.
Mm-hmm.
And our people are like, no, our vote doesn't count, this, and that, and the third. People died for us to vote.
Exactly.
We need to voice our opinion on voting.
That's
Stop
right.
being idiots.
And not just wait till, you know, big major elections, because it starts in your community.
Exactly.
Even from your home own, you know, from your home ownership community or whatever. Go to the things that matter, like your school boards. Pay attention to who's on your city council. You know, at every level, that's what matters more so than who sits as the figurehead.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because I know we had the young lady on the show not too long ago that kind of have taken Conyers by storm, her and another another friend that they went and ran for city council and won. Yeah. And now they're, you know, and they're shaking up things, and they did everything to keep them out. I mean, like everything. They smeared them, you know, did a smear campaign, sent emails out to different people. I mean, they did a lot of stuff, and they still end up winning. So that's, you know, to me, that's the good part about, you know, government, because we still have to put somebody in charge.
Yeah.
But we as people, we have to remember to hold them accountable. And that's where we drop the ball. Because at all levels, we have to say, we have to show up to the school boards and say, listen, but why aren't our kids passing state assessments? You know, why don't our kids have the right proper tools? So, you know, all of that kind of stuff matter. Well, what's your take? What's your take, Chimia?
Yeah, to piggyback on what you said, yes, we have to make sure that we have the right people in Congress and the Senate and everything else, because these are people who make the laws. Mm-hmm. The president only enforces what the laws are given, signs off, say, hey, this is what the law is. But Congress and the Senate are the ones who are going to make the laws. If we want things to change, we have to make sure we have those right people in office, too.
Yeah, absolutely.
And make sure that they're going for, you know, everybody's everybody's opinions, not just their own agendas or their corporate agendas, you know, those.
Well, you know, let's face it. When it come down to it, the money matter.
Money do matter.
Money talk
and BS walk. Bleep, we all know it.
Yeah, walks. It's a marathon.
So we all know. We all know. But as long as we have enough people that be like, okay, but so do these issues. These issues also matter.
Absolutely.
We understand, you know, hey, it's a business. We know.
The problem is they don't never stick to the issues. We can go and which we got to really hold them accountable for. We got to really force the issues on them.
That's right.
They get sidetracked a lot.
Oh, because bribery is real.
It's really real.
They can bribe me.
Bribery, retaliation, all types of things, intimidation. A lot of things happen to people who really want to make a difference, as you said. Mm-hmm. You know, they'll smear you. They'll pick up your pass. They'll pick at every little piece of nook and cranny and try to throw it into the fire and everything else. But you have to be strong enough to stand tall.
If Trump can get elected, I can get elected. Put somebody behind me.
Lord, we need a bell. We need the bell on that one.
So what do you think about that? He's still in the race, right? I'm so far removed.
I don't.
Well, I'm a CNN junkie. I watch that.
Okay, so that's good.
That one.
And so my thoughts.
Somebody
is
needs to.
On that is like they had a chance to get him out of office with the impeachment, and now that the only. Mitch Romney, shots out to Mitch Romney, because he was the only Republican that went against him in the whole vote. Mm-hmm. And for him to go against his own party, that man brought tears to my eyes. Mm-hmm. For one, because he was like, you know, he's a man of God and he's for the people. And he's like, the president is dead wrong. And the rest of the Republicans should be get off their high horses and stop being scared of that man and go against him. So now they want to go against him now. Because of this whole little issue with the coronavirus and everything and stuff like that. That's a whole other subject for me.
Yeah.
I don't even want
to.
We're going to hit that.
Because people, they tell me people dying. I'm
like this. Because I'm getting ready to fly home to Michigan for a funeral.
Mm-hmm.
And you know all my issues with the kidney disease and everything and stuff. People be like, Antonio, aren't you scared? You know what? If it's my time to go, it's going to be my time to go.
Okay. So.
It's in God's will.
Yeah, I know.
I'm
going
to travel, enjoy life, and do whatever I want
to
do.
Because I'm sure I'm going to London.
Because it's another pharmaceutical billion-dollar thing.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So they can get
that check.
Are we
ready to talk about the coronavirus?
Might as well. We done jumped
in. Freestyle Sunday. You know, I'm like.
Okay. So let me.
What you got, co-host? It take co-host a minute to get it together.
I'm telling you, because I don't be wanting to snap off at one point in time. Just be honest. Let me explain something to everybody. This is nothing new under the sun, okay? If you pay attention, and I think the first time I actually heard of the human coronavirus was back when the Gulf War was going on. And they called it SARS.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same thing, people. Mm-hmm. It's the same thing given, manufactured, and given to somebody else. And that's why when people started looking at the back of their Lysol cans, if you hadn't noticed, it's on there. Well, why would it be on there? It's been on there forever. Because nothing is new under the sun. So them bulking it up is almost like them screaming Ebola again. That didn't last, what, 3 days?
3 days.
Like 3 days.
But that's like everything.
Yeah, you if you hype it enough and people grab onto it.
Look over there. Look over there. They want you to look over there.
Look over there because we got this going on over here. We got a distraction. Mm-hmm. That's basically what goes into play. Now, guys, remember that this happens from unclean environments, foods, and things of that nature. Most black people, we keep bleach, Lysol, ammonia, Ajax, Purell. We don't go nowhere. Mixed you cough, we're not supposed you to be cough in our direction. Be ready
house
to
be all fumed up.
Okay,
we run
that's
out of
what's
house.
Gonna kill us. Yeah, the house is gonna smell like okay. That's what I'm saying. The house is gonna smell so good, and it's gonna you gonna be like, girl, you was cleaning. Yep, I can smell the bleach. Okay, we're not.
Down the street, you can smell it.
Down the street.
Too much of it, you're going to be in there passed out.
Passed out.
But my, all the doors.
But my house is clean. I'm germaphobe free. That's what I got going on. But see, that's the thing. You got to know what's causing it. In these certain areas, especially with China and everything else, not everything in China. I'm not saying anything about
but,
China.
But then, too, they said this, that every time that there's a economic crisis, that they have to create some type of disease or whatever. So there's an economic crisis going on in China, and they had to make this thing come about to say, okay, this is what's happening, this is what's happening, this is what's happening.
China is one of the first or second richest countries in the world, but they don't get Africa its credit because Africa, you got diamonds and gold in Africa. To me, that should be the richest continent, along with you have, you know, of course you got the Middle East with the oil, but at the same time, China doesn't really produce anything that we use but technology.
Which is big.
Which
big,
is very
huge.
Big.
Which is the way
our
we...
Sony, our iPhones,
it's
our
everything.
And
big.
Everything comes from, you know, pretty much comes from China.
Okay, but everybody's still getting stuff from China. Everybody's getting stuff. I just got clothes.
But see, then, too, China's media has a media cap, so you're not even
going
to know what they have going on because they only release what they want us to know, what they want us to exploit is the
and
only
that's
thing
what
that...
Trump is trying to do now. He's trying... He put Mike Pence with the... so-called coronavirus crew or whatever, and they're only going to, he's like, well, we're only going to let the CDC release so much information. And like Mike Pybon, what's the Democrat name that's in head of the, somebody help me
don't
out.
Don't ask
Mike
me.
Mike Schumer, whatever his name is.
Oh, okay, I heard of that guy.
The one that always goes to get strong, he's a Democrat. Nancy Pelosi's boy. Whatever his name is, he was like, the president needs to stop lying to the American people. And it was like they said, when they had a chance to get him out of office, they should have got him out of office. That's their fault. They should have stopped kissing ass and just got him out of office. Oops,
well,
my bad.
Okay.
No,
everything's set up. Understand everything. Everything gets to be set up. So what they did was they have enough evidence. But you know, and it's true, you can impeach him, but they want him gone. So they want to
like
gone. Yeah, some people. Unfortunately, I'm not gonna say some people do
we
want him gone.
Up here on the next show.
I know, right? No, they're not.
No.
They're
what
not
I'm saying
watching.
Is handcuffs going to prison type deals, and so you can't do that.
Well,
why?
Gone.
Yeah, but that's gone.
Well, that's true. They figure if they after the election, that's if he doesn't get a second term. I don't put nothing behind people.
You don't think he'll win?
I think he probably will win. Just
he will.
Out of some crazy
I think he will.
Spite. I feel like out of spite.
And then that's gonna
be the turning point.
Exactly.
Because see, if he gets,
he gonna buy that black vote.
If he gets it, and it's gonna be out of spite.
It's
and
not
and
so
it's
much
gonna come out. Yeah.
Cause
spike.
Like,
come on now, the Simpsons ain't be playing with you.
I'm
you
doing
know?
Justice reform for the black community.
We remember he was a Democrat at first. The whole political melting pot is just a big game. It's like what you step on whatever side will get your agenda passed. You said on whatever side will get you. You know, like putting your lobbyists in there for different things. I was talking to last night. He has Beverly Foundation, Cunningham Foundation. Some of you might know him here in Atlanta. But his platform was against domestic violence. And he said, well, Wanda, I have to shift now more into AIDS awareness because they're not giving monies to domestic violence. And so he's up there lobbying for money. And I was like, wow, everything's so political. And he was like, everything. Mm-hmm. So even with him on this nonprofit foundation that he does a lot of work, good work, it's like he needs the funding. And sometimes when you need the funding, you got to switch over. You know, you just got to go over on that side of the street to go get the money. Yeah, and it's sad, but that's just the game of politics.
Yeah, but Trump came out a long time ago saying he would go Republican because he thought they were stupid.
Yeah, he did.
And he's proving their point.
I mean, he said it a long time ago when he was young. He was like, oh, if I was running, I'd run Republican. Oh, yeah. Because they're a bunch of idiots. He said that live. I don't know if people looked at
him. Oh, yeah, I know. Because I'm very familiar with old Trump boy. But anyway.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, it's just they all want to get to, like I said, they want to buy our votes. They want to say that we're doing this or we did this for the black community. Like Michael Bloomberg, what Bumberg is, he was like, well, I did this and there's more black businesses growing on now and life is different here in New York for my black people. Why we got to be the black people? Why has life got to be different for us? Why just can't we just be all equally human beings? Well, we're all foreigners. We all was brought over here on the boat. Even the white folks came over here on the boat. They came over from Europe.
But
Britain,
we are different.
Yes, we are. We're very different.
They should pay us what they need to pay us. That would be the start of giving us what we need.
Every foreign person that comes over here gets some money for a school, open a business. You got more. We live in Atlanta. I know everybody notices this. More Koreans and Japanese people own more chicken places in Atlanta and hairdressers or nail salons and anything else when this is a black community, a black state.
Yeah.
And how come we can't own a lot of, we should be investing in our own communities, even from the liquor stores.
Well, we have to have a community first to invest in. You know, it used to be a time where we had communities. Now they're so, we really don't have the community base like we used to back like in the 60s before the first riots. Yeah. Is when we really had communities, when you really had your mom and pop stores mm-hmm. and grocery stores and banks and all this other kind of stuff. It's so different now. So when you talk about investing, I think it really needs to go into, if you go try to get a loan, you should be given the loan based on you, not all of these roadblocks, and every time you get to the line and you think you're about to cross it, they move the line back over. Oh, well, you need one more piece of document. You need to prove this. You need to prove that. You know, that's where the whole separation comes in, to where, yes, we are different, but if we were to really wake up and put all of our resources together, we could get a lot further. But what happens is, even take a look at like Hollywood, and you have people making big fat checks, they'll still go and want to get on the white man's platform as opposed to band together and create their own platform.
That's why Tyler Perry a lot of huge respect. That man has built his own company. They didn't want to produce his movies. He said, you know what, the hell with y'all. I don't need y'all to. I built my own damn studio. And that's exactly what he did. And now he got everyone from Motion Pictures want to shoot at his studio now. So now they paying this man to shoot at his studios now. The white man paying him,
yeah,
which is phenomenal. You know, if it was a time that they didn't want to give him no type of props.
Oh, yeah.
Or no type
he
of
had to, He had to build the table.
He had to build the table. Like, you know what? I built my table. I'm going to eat at my own table.
Yeah. But it's still so much building that we need to do, you know, in respects to just how everything is still upside down. Yeah. And it's still, the scales are still, you know, they're not going to be fair. And let's face it, they probably won't be fair in this lifetime. But what we have to do, I feel strongly about, we have to come to awareness, is to focus on what really matters for you, for your family, for your legacy. You know, like to focus on, like, really, really, what do I need to be paying attention to? And we run after shiny things. We kind of get distracted in terms of, okay, like if you know, for instance, now let's solve some of these issues right here. If you know you want to start a business and your credit sucks, why aren't you working on your credit? Why are you still buying things that you can't afford, like pocketbooks and going on trips and stuff like this? Why are you trying to impress somebody as opposed to work on what will get you what you need? Because
God,
at the
conversation the other day with some business people, they're like, because people, they like to live like the others when they're,
But that's the cycle of being with your eyes shut. Mm-hmm. You know, if I'm trying to really, if I really want to open up the school and I know it's going to take me $100,000 and or I need $1 million+ credit line, then all I need to do is put myself in the right position to raise up my credit score. So then I can get a line of credit that will support what I need. Then I can use other people's money. But if you keep letting your lights get turned off and your cars get foreclosed, you know, and your houses get foreclosed and
your cars get repossessed,
then you can't really blame
the other people.
You can't, you know, so you really can't. At some point, it's like, when do we
take responsibility?
You know, we can hold everybody accountable, but we have to hold ourselves accountable at first. You know, that's the first person in line.
Somebody posted a question on Facebook, like, what would you do if you had like $2 million
mm-hmm.
and what kind of business would you open up? I said, I'll open up a dispensary. They jumped on me like, what would you do with why would you open a dispensary up? I'm like, don't you know? Weed is money.
Mm-hmm.
Marijuana stocks are booming right now.
Absolutely.
And she's like, well, don't you know every time the government get their hands on stuff, it messes up?
And what?
She's like, you shouldn't do that.
So what did she suggest? What was her alternative?
She didn't have one.
Exactly.
That was the thing.
See, that's the problem.
I'm like this. She's like, well, all for you. I don't know what you're going to blow your money.
Look.
I'll show you better. I can tell you.
Right. We were talking about that, about mm-hmm. people not following behind what you got going on because they can't see your vision ahead of what you got going on. Which is true, and that's the weird part. That's why when you ask those questions and people start coming at you, you be like, "What? Ain't this? Yeah, this is my table. I remember. Okay, so I want to make sure this is my table. I didn't invite you to my table. You're welcome to go to the door. I mean, that's the crazy part about people. If you want to build something, build it.
Right.
If you want to do what you want to do with your money, then you do what you want to do with your money. The only problem is that I feel that when people decide that they want to make a business, this is a trending thing again. It's like anything else. When people go buy shoes, it's a trending thing. Like purses, houses, cars, it's all a trending thing because that's the thing that's in. Some of them really don't be in it to win it. They mm-hmm. really be like, oh, I got a business. Mm-hmm. So they can flash a business card.
It sounds good. Superficial status.
You know, that artificial status. And you'd be looking like, so what's your business do? Oh, well, I'm still working on it. 5-6 years later, I see a lot of your business cards. Where's your plan? I'm still. Yeah, it was never your real intention. And you know what I'm saying? People.
The status quo.
Right. It's about the trend. It's about what is out, what is popular, what is trending.
Yeah, you said something too, Chef, when you talked about social media. Oh. And I had saw on social media where a female, she gave a guy a rental property for his birthday, right? So, and he was not really feeling that rental property. He said, you know, like, I'd rather have some shoes or something, some clothes or whatever. And they were like, they you know, and so his friends was like, man, you got, and he said, what's that? And it was like a bottle of cologne. And what's that? A deed to a rental property. And it just went totally overhead. Two things. First of all, ladies, wake up. Do not be buying no man, no rental property if y'all not in a legal binding marriage. Okay. First of all,
don't even do it
because you are not, that's just wrong on so many levels. Okay. Yeah. Let's not go there.
It doesn't. I wouldn't do it either because I'm not finna buy no woman no property and she's not my wife. We have to be building together as a couple.
Exactly.
Not as a boyfriend,
girlfriend. And secondly, that's the wrong guy. If you are thinking about investing and you have the mindset, you got the wrong partner if he didn't appreciate them keys in his hands. Okay, so two things. Because if you was to go get it for me, I'm like, okay, thank you. I'm appreciated. I'm be like, I'm like, yes, let's do it. When we get the second one. But for the reasons of, he said, what is she doing? I don't want this. That, take this thing back.
He wanted to turn up and everything.
Yeah, he wanted some. He wanted some bling bling, some flashiness.
I could have jumped through that Facebook screen just to choke him. Like, are you an idiot?
Yeah, I'm like, well, honey, take it with you and go ahead and do what you got to do with it.
I know, I know. But guys, thank you for joining us so far. You know, like I said, this Freestyle Sunday, we got some beautiful people in the building. Let me, did y'all know Tina B in here, right?
Yeah.
Tina B, you know, she in the back of the room. She in the back of the room. She did this play that was phenomenal. Like, I'm telling you, we got so much talent in Atlanta to where, and I'm so glad that I'm just finger on the pulse. She put this play together called A Shell of a Man. And when I tell you,
you didn't cast me,
you will be crying. Don't worry. You're going to probably, you know, she's still traveling around the country with this thing. So this play was so dynamic. And we talked about this earlier today, talking about people really following their gifts and operating on the do instead of the I should be doing. She's one of those people that's doing it, you know. Just totally, she probably wake up every night saying, I want to do something, and she just go do it. And that's how, you know, that's how we should be when we come to a point in our life of understanding that we can do anything.
That's right.
And regardless of all the obstacles and hoops that we have to jump through, we still can do anything. We are, and I'm just going to say this, no disrespect to anybody else, but I love my people. Black people, we've been through enough to have the thickest skin ever. So with that being said, we need to really come outside of caring what other people think, caring about how many no's, how much we're going to get turned down, what don't matter. We talked about this.
Yes.
Don't matter if the book don't got some misspelled words in it or if the cover ain't right the first time. Just go ahead and do it. And then go back and correct it. Just keep doing it. Keep doing it until you perfect it and master your craft. You know, that's what goes on. You know, when I first started on this whole media platform, and my very first producer is in the room, we came and we met, and I said, I'm doing this. And I think 2 weeks later, I was launching in the space of internet TV, just like that. Didn't know much. Don't know much with, as far as working boards and hitting buttons. But all I knew is that I needed what I needed, and this looked like a good thing for me at the time. And it wasn't. I still see people sitting on the sideline saying, "I'm going to get started. I'm gonna do that." And a year passes, and I got some books I'm working on. When are they gonna come out? You know, when I worked with Karen, it was like magic because we're totally different. She's very analytical, you know. I got to say the right words, and I never say the right words right. And she's like, what did you say? What did you mean? Like, so, you know, I'm like, Karen, come on, the thingamajing, the whatchamacallit. She's like, "You, what are you talking about?" You know, so, but it's that beautiful blend. It's that beautiful blend that makes the magic, because you don't have to know everything to get started. You don't have to. Desire, right, to get started and get going.
That's
And keep going.
Talk, I was like, where did you come up with the name for I Am Enough at?
Right.
And then when you explained it to me, I was like, you know what? That rocks.
Yeah.
You know, see the thought behind it in the process. Because as you think about it, everything like we go through, you're like, you know, I had enough of this. I'm tired. I had enough of it. I'm like, that's a great concept.
Mm-hmm.
That's a great brand for you.
And then to do it, you know, you got to just keep on doing. We have to keep on being in front of what we want to.
Your dreams.
Our dreams. We can't abandon our dreams. Nobody else gives a shit about what you got going on. And if you don't care,
or you'll bail that for that one.
Then nobody cares.
I'm serious.
I mean, nobody really cares. Because, you know, when I started, like, the Wake Up Winning, when I started that about 5-6 years ago, it was some time ago. I don't know. I'm, you know, whatever. But It was because I needed to be held accountable. So I would just get up with my own motivation, my own self-motivation. And then it just kind of like grew. It grew. Right, because I never go to sleep, right? So it's like I need that push. And then, two, if whatever you're doing, you got to keep doing it. Like, if you're a chef, so you got to keep preparing a meal every day. You can't just, like, take a month off. And I will watch people get started, stop. Get started, stop. And I will always try to be, like, the encouragement. Then I had to learn how to just be quiet and let them do them. So if they want to get started and stop, I'll be like, okay, I see you over there, you know. And I would say, but, you know, you're brilliant. But if they didn't catch on to that, then that wasn't my business. But in doing that, I had to say, this is the area for me. And I don't really care about who – I'm not trying to impress anybody. Trying to get invited here or there. I'm just wanting to do what I was in my spirit to do, mm-hmm. you know, in honoring – my ancestors. So when that comes down to the truth, that's my truth and that's my order. So as we come on this platform, just showing everybody how they can you know, wake up winning no matter what, how they can, you know, believe that they're enough, inciting affirmations, concentrating on the right things, getting people out of your way that don't belong there, you know, getting around people that do, and you'll realize that creatives stick together and, mm-hmm. and it's a small group because it's more people watching what you do than doing what you do.
Yeah, that's right.
You know,
one of my mentors said
that's right.
Like, even like on social media, on Facebook, even though they're not commenting or not saying that,
oh, they see you.
People see you. People watch you.
Oh, they see you.
Constantly watching you and
I see you
absorbing
too.
You. They know they're keeping their eyes on you. They may not say nothing, but they're watching you.
Right.
Yeah. Like that's
absolutely
the biggest thing. He's like, you have to really. He's like, just keep doing what you're doing. He said, don't matter who's watching.
Right, because you in the game. You in the game, Chef. You, and there's two types of people. People that's in the game and people that watches the game. So when you're in the game, you are going to be watched because you're in the game. And sometimes people are keeping up with your scores, but you so busy being in the game, you ain't even keeping up with your scores. Nah. They be like, oh, you did that or da-da-da. You be like, what? I don't even remember that. I'm over here doing.
I got 4 or 5 years. You see the stat sheet like, oh, okay.
Yeah, you're not even looking back because if you stop and you look back, then you're not in the game.
You're not in the game.
You're taking a backtrack. So that being said, I just want to – we're going to take a short break, but before when we take this break, I want to tell you about some things that we have going on. So as we take this break, I'm just going to go through some different things that we have coming up here soon in the Atlanta area.
Yes, in Atlanta area.
Yeah. So first we have the Amber Lyons, she's here in, yeah, that's good. She's here in Atlanta, and she has the Teen Spotlight Awards that's coming up soon here. And she had put out this post of getting people to nominate people. You know, this is an honor to children that have, or I should say teens, that have gone through some things. And having a hard time just getting people to honor to nominate, I should say, to nominate their young people into the for the nominations. And what they do is, if you say you know of a teenager or a young adult that has really gone through some type of tragedy or whatever, and you want to nominate them because they're still utilizing their gifts and talents. And their gifts and talents, they don't have to be a singer or anything like that. They could be really gifted in caring for other people, you know, or playing sports or whatever. So people need to reach out to her. If you're on, it's, what is it? what's her organization? From Pain to Purpose. From Pain to Purpose. And you can find her on Facebook. She's everywhere on all social media. And let her know that you have, maybe you have a young person that you want to nominate, or you want to participate in this event, because she also needs sponsors. So we're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to see what Chef got going on.
Not much.
Little this, little that.
You know.
One minute you could be alone.
Entangled. I am not as naive as Little Red Riding Hood, though I'm not as brave as Michelle Obama or Coretta Scott King. Risking my life to fight a cause? I think not. But who knows? Who knows? Today I stand for the voiceless, the hopeless, the prisoners of unjust and lost souls. The penniless, the unassured, the elderly cast away, the enslaved categorized as minors. I keep standing so they don't pass away. Time tells a path to follow. Will tomorrow ever come? My heart beats to heat waves of yesterday. Hopscotch, lollipops, penny candy and skate parties. Looking for red lights and dungeons and kisses of sweet beats. Behind the candles meltdown, wax everywhere, roll bounce, yeah, roll bounce, you know, parking lots that misdirect, I can't squeeze my mind between the lines and box up my thoughts, I dreamed of the pops I never knew, did he look like me and how did he walk, how did he talk and why did he leave? His little girl fatherless, to crush beats on pavement and blackened concrete. Skid marks on upside down dreams. Mary Poppins and My Fair Lady, that just doesn't seem real to me. Can't get over the rainbow, too cold in the desert. Sunbeams telling lies behind scenes. Wallpaper hiding art, despair to tricky things. Madness on eclipse of harvesting moonlight, plowed and pulled in all directions. Between rhythm and rhyme, interludes or unsung preludes on steroids, looking for my hero. I'm just looking for my hero. Have you seen my hero? So sweet, I kiss the streets, make vows to the unknown. In the trenches is where I eat. Birth to babies, discarded feces, wrapped in brown paper bags, watching buildings burn as we all turn into ash. Entangled. In the end, we all turn into ash. Soak down deep. in your mind, and like a sponge, my desires to soak up all your thoughts. Play with Cupid's arrow until you get caught behind the sharp spear that whispers in your ear. From old school to new school, ballads and iTunes, keep up with the snapping new jack. Yeah, you deserve a big pat on the back. Or should I sit in your lap, dancing? I'll be your private dancer, no money needed, I'll do it for fun. Sex in the city, or in the ride, pull up in the driveway, happy days. Baby, they're here to stay. Tickets to the show, mystery, sci-fi, or drama. Bring on the comedy. Did I just wet my pants, or was that a dream? Expand on them in detention, 15 rounds in the ring. Heavyweight champion, my heart is capable of more. And when you think of me, I want you to believe that our paths were destined to cross. You'll fall to the floor, knocked out. Because the joy in my heart was once lost. The writings on the wall, was all that surgery necessary? To get into MySpace, Facebook, or on my channel, I'm trying to create something new, different, and great. But just like playing chess, be careful of the next move you make. Return to planets of the eight, perhaps a kiss, maybe a hug, but one thing for sure, I'll be there to show you love. Yeah, I'll be there to show you love.
Welcome back to the I Am Enough, to the talk show.
To the talk show.
Yes.
The talk show.
So we have moved some people over. These are some of our studio audience, and I just wanted to bring them in for this full experience of being here on the show. So I want to say to you guys, thank you. And I'm going to have you introduce yourself in just a moment. And also, you know what, y'all, this is what y'all miss when y'all not here in the studio. It be so much fire going on off the cameras, and we'd be like, hush, just wait till we come back on. But you know, that's how the people do it. The people. Thank you.
Power to the people. There we go. Yes. Okay.
Power to the people.
I love the unity.
So we had a little controversy. If y'all checked out the clip earlier when we were talking about the whole Facebook and the man that bought the house, and some of my people, they spoke out, but they didn't have a mic. So we want to just get them a mic so they could put on. Hold on for 1 second. Hold on. So first, I want everybody to introduce themselves. Okay. Starting with my love.
Hi, everybody. I'm Lakeisha. I am a business owner. I own Designer Events by Lakeisha, where we specialize in corporate event planning and interior design for homes and offices in Atlanta. And I'm from Atlanta. Okay. I'm having a wonderful time on the show.
Thank you.
My name is Fitzgerald Breland. I own Breland's Universe. We are a real estate company. I am a realtor. I'm from L.A. Well, from all over. I'm a Navy brat. I'm from L.A. Coming to Atlanta. And everybody should own something.
Hi, everyone. I'm Nicole Adams. I am the author of Harper's Way. It's a series. There are two books out now, Harper's Way, The Way to Greet, about community helpers, and Harper's Way, The Way to Give, about giving.
Awesome. Okay, awesome. So thank you, guys. Ding, 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 ding. Okay, so did y'all enjoy the first half? Was it kind of spicy?
It was very spicy.
A little spicy?
Controversial.
That's what I promised. I promised it to be a little, you know, and there's no subjects kind of like off, you know, off limits. So, you know, we were just talking about the hot button of the Facebook post and the guy that received the rental property. So, Fitzgerald,
yes,
what do you think about that action?
So, we were talking about how a female brought her boyfriend a piece of property,
uh-huh,
and the and the boyfriend wanted like a Gucci belt or a Gucci watch. Shoes or a watch. Something stupid. No, well, I mean, you know, that's his goals, right? That's his dreams.
His goals.
Right, but my thing was, if you're the boyfriend or the girlfriend of that person and you buy them something that they don't appreciate, mm-hmm. it's your obligation to educate them on why they need to understand the value of that piece of property or whatever it is. Because as people of color, mm-hmm. we got to start understanding the value of ownership. And if we're in relationships with people, obviously there are things that we like about that person. But the things that we don't understand or don't agree with, mm-hmm. you have to educate them on those things so that they understand the value of that piece of property or whatever it is.
Okay.
You can't just throw that person away mm-hmm. because they don't understand the value of something. You gotta get them to, you gotta educate them, because as people of color, we gotta own stuff.
Yeah.
Can I hold you on one question on that?
Sure.
If he understands the value of a Gucci belt and a Gucci watch, he should understand the value of property.
Not necessarily, because we have been educated. We have been wrongly educated as people of color mm-hmm. for generations.
Talking your mic.
Okay. We have been educated to think that. Can I be frank? Can I be 100?
I hope.
It's freestyle. Hey, come on with it.
It's freestyle Sunday.
It's freestyle Sunday. So black folks have been educated to think that other people's stuff matters. We've been educated to think that white folks know everything.
Talking your mic though.
And they don't know everything. So, and they don't want to give us nothing. So in order for us to understand and, mm-hmm. and gain value, we as a people have to educate each other.
Right.
Right. So if we're dating somebody and somebody brings us value, mm-hmm. but it's not all that value, mm-hmm. those things that they don't understand, we got to educate them.
I get it.
I do too, but.
So basically what you're saying is, like, he could be a great guy in certain areas because, you know, she like him or whatever.
Yes.
She, you know, and that's her dude. That's clearly her dude because she bought him a house
yes.
and some cologne. Yes. Okay, but you're saying that we should educate during our relationship, so to point out why I bought you this rental property and the value of it, and then that's a great thing. And I get it. And I would have to say I agree with
Wanda. Everybody's not going to be on the same level as each other. When you're in relationships,
is your mic on?
Is it blue?
Okay, yeah. So just talk in it, just up in your.
If you're dating somebody and they bring something to the table, they might not bring 100% of what you bring to the table.
Mm-hmm.
So that 85% that they bring, you appreciate.
Look at these faces.
Love and. Right?
But I mean, because
15%. Okay. You gotta guide them.
You can't.
Wait. I'm the moderator. So pass the mic over. And yes, my love, beloved, you say what you got to say.
So what would he be bringing to her table if she's explaining everything to him?
That pipe.
Well, one, she's not explaining everything to him. She's explaining to him the value of owning a house.
Why would he not know that before he took on a lady?
We don't know their whole story.
Right, but if she's explaining all these things to him about future partnership, why does she need him?
Okay, hold on. Okay, first of all, this how this go. Beloved,
yes,
you have the mic.
Yes,
so she has the floor. Okay, so that's how we do that. So in respect. With that, what I said was, then this was my, because see, everything is from your perspective.
Right.
And we all have different perspectives. Right. So my perspective was, I would not have bought a boyfriend a rental property.
Right. You would have bought it for your husband.
So it's right. So we, and then me and my husband, we're in a contractual relationship.
Right.
And our relationship should be about gaining wealth. Building a foundation together. Mm-hmm. See, and this is a whole, it's Freestyle Sunday, so I could go a lot of places
with
this.
And I agree with that too.
So the point that I made was, the first of all, it's twofold. The whole we're boyfriend, we're dating. So there's going to be some boundaries to what I'm going to do with you and for you,
right?
Just because we're dating. Now, like Beyonce say, put a ring on it. Like, if we're going to do it all the way, put a ring on it. But hold on. Yes, you can, but hold on. So when you made that choice to do it, it seemed to me that the person you made it for or with was not prepared to receive the gift.
Right.
It's kind of like, this can go a lot of ways. This is why I recommend that all couples go and do the 5 love language tests, mm-hmm. to see what their desires are, what they need. Who are you talking to? It's like anything, like who's talking, who is talking.
And how to love your partner.
And how to love your partner. So with me, my love language is communications.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it has nothing to do with material things. You know, I'd be like, whatever. So it's like the intelligence has to be stimulated for me. So for somebody else, for other people, it may be that you show me you love me by giving me a gift.
Right.
And that gift has to be of value to me in my mental mind. So this is why I'm saying I agree with Fitzgerald. If his capacity was just to receive a Rolex watch or the whole mindset of I need jewelry and clothes, that's fine. That might be the way he get down. Mm-hmm. But that's not somebody that I would have bought a house for to begin with without
That's what I'm saying. Under
the understanding of where we're going with it.
And then if he doesn't understand the value of a house, that's what I was saying, like having to teach him, and you're teaching him. And then so, he's not your son. And then so it's like you're teaching him. But what is he teaching you? Like, what's he bringing to your table?
Right, and that's a little
Boyfriend,
right?
As a boyfriend,
and there lies understanding the relationship,
right?
Mm-hmm. Because girlfriend, you already know where it comes to relationship. People need different things,
yeah.
And for she might need it. Whatever she needs.
Yeah.
So that could be the top of her list. So I've met a whole bunch of people that say, you know, I'll go out there and cash the checks.
I mean, that's fine if that's their relationship.
But
if she's having to explain to him, that's what I'm saying. It's like,
right.
But what you do.
From Fitzgerald's point is, let us, and I feel you, brother, because, you know, me and his brother, we go back a long way. I'm just going to talk about the dynamics of the panel's relationship.
Mm-hmm.
When you care about your people, you do want to educate them. So of a whole thing of this not even being a romantic involvement, let me just educate you on understanding the value of possessions. And, you know, for me to say a property, I wouldn't buy it. Well, back in the day, I wouldn't have bought somebody a pair of shoes or notebook.
Depends.
You know, so it just depends on my own, where I'm at, you know, and what I want to do.
Right.
But I think we do definitely lack education within our whole entire community.
Mm-hmm.
This is why people become renters for so long, and they've literally paid for a property over and over and over again,
mm-hmm.
because they don't understand the value in ownership. So that's all I think Fitzgerald was saying, is just like, we have to get behind that understanding that what's valuable, you know, in that other people's stuff. And this is full 180 in our own community, you know, like, you'll go, I made a post the other day. I posted something about cheesecake and saying how you can get a cheesecake slice.
Mm-hmm.
I had that post shared 10 times on a cheesecake, but I post about the show or somebody else's event. Crickets.
Right.
Nothing.
Share.
No shares. And that's like the whole mindset of us. It's like, you mean to tell me y'all promoting the Cheesecake Factory? And I did it for an experiment. See, when I do stuff, it be for experiment. My whole truth of my life is
my family, my friends, and my work. That's it. I don't really care nothing about nothing else. But I don't really care about showing you what restaurants, they not paying me to endorse them, baby. Or a movie. I don't really care nothing about that. But when I do that, I watch for the reaction. And the reaction was, whoo, well, you know, somebody's type, well, you know, that's just DoorDash. I said, well, there I go getting me some DoorDash. I'm not getting ready to get no DoorDash or not even interested in a cheesecake, you know, but I just wanted to do that for the whole state of, let's see where this is going to go. And it took off as though, that's the same thing. Check this out. If you was to say you got a new job, people like, thumbs up, way to go, you got, but if you say you're opening up your business, and my business is going to do this, and da-da-da, and will you support me?
Why are you doing that? And what are you going to do? You think you're better than that?
Crickets. Okay. So yeah, Chef, what you got going on in the kitchen? What?
Cheddar on a sun-dried tomato pesto with the herb mozzarella balls. With prosciutto.
What?
Yeah, but
you know what, Chef? I meant to ask you this. You know, this Freestyle Sunday, right?
Yeah, let's freestyle it up.
Okay,
it's
so
the first of the month.
It's the first of the month.
So get them checks up. And come on.
Wake up. Okay, so you got those hematite bracelets on.
Healthy.
So you want to tell them about them bracelets?
Well, sure. Why not? This is a graphite hematite bracelet. I wear it on quite a bit. For one, I have stupid high blood pressure, and to where, you know, it's, for one, it keeps my blood pressure at a calm, municipal rate and everything.
Educated today.
It's hematite. I might be pronouncing the word wrong. Miss teacher over there, did I get it right? You know, she likes to correct me, so especially on Facebook. You know you spelled that wrong.
Oh, yeah, we got one of them on our team, too.
But, it not only does it keep my blood pressure and everything at a, you know, calm rate, it also keeps my iron and my body flowing with everything else.
A bracelet.
Because it's
the
one
stones
of those
and the,
gemstones mm-hmm. and minerals.
You know, fresh herbs, you know, just like what you, when you're eating like fresh herbs and rosemary. Like, for instance, these that I have here, they're fresh herbs, not the smoking herbs, but these are is fresh rosemary.
But they're still fresh.
You know, so this is rosemary. So when you freshly chop this up, it releases all the pheromones in it and everything and stuff. And you, when you add it with the food, it gives your food a better flavor. Just for like, instead of using fresh rosemary that already is not fresh, but using rosemary that's in the shaker, for instance. You use
but
this.
You don't know how long it's been on
there. You don't know how long it's been on the shelf or nothing like that. Then you have fresh, I have fresh basil. Which, you know, smells real good. You know, this is what I have in there as well, too. This you can use for any types of, any foods.
Can I ask a quick sidebar question?
Yeah.
You need a mic.
Mr. Microphone Fiend.
So, when they talk about seedless fruit, is it, aren't you supposed to eat fruit that's got seeds in it?
No, not necessarily. Okay. Not necessarily. I mean, because it's produced from the seed of the fruit. You know, because like you have seedless grapes, for instance.
Right, and watermelon.
Yeah, which are still good. Got to get the mic. Just remember the mic when you talk. Brother. It's that run punch, ain't it? You know, we gotta remember
that.
We're
going to cut off his mic. Don't worry. He done. He done for the day. He's going
to
be done.
Didn't bring none and share none of that. But, yeah, you know, like back to the bracelets, you know, it's, you know, fresh minerals. Like they have fresh mineral water, fresh graphite. Mm-hmm. You know, it's healthy for your body. So, you know, as Wanda was saying, I wear these quite a bit all the time. Keeps the blood circulating.
Bracelet does that.
Like, you know how they say people burn sage. When you burn sage through your house, keeps the spirits out of the house. Same process.
So, Chef, go ahead. Tell us what you got going on.
Got quite a few things going on. But first, can I talk about the Pamper Party for a quick second?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, hot diggity dog. Ladies. Who like to get pampered. This ladies' pamper party is exclusive for ladies only. Sorry, fellas. I don't cater to y'all unless you bring your women with you. But this is going to be an exclusive ladies pamper party. I'm going to have a guy that does massages, facials, medicure, pedicures, a young lady that comes and do the bedroom by Candies. I have a young lady that's do some nice little girly, womanly drinks for you, like for the ladies. I'm putting together a nice menu for that. Ladies are going to come out, have a good time, get yourself pampered. Get those feet massaged, hands done, facials, drink, turn up, and have a good time. So that's June 13th. So that's the first event. And then the next event that everybody can come to, even the men and gentlemen, is going to be the erotic art party. I knew you would want the details on that one.
Oh, Lord. So when is the erotic art party?
I haven't set the date for that yet, but I'm just
and
got
what kind of art is it? Is it body art?
Body art.
Okay, so we're gonna be painted and walking around naked.
Exactly.
Oh yeah.
I have ladies walking. I might even get a few gentlemen for the ladies. That's a little bit of but my mind is all women.
Okay.
So it's gonna be women
like,
walking
around. More for me.
Women walking around with painted bodies. I'm gonna have a young lady on a table. Wrapped in plastic with food on top of her naked. And I'm going to have ladies walking around with lingerie. And my business partner, Lakeisha, over there, what am I going to do with you? I'm going to have models walking around with painted arts on their bodies, some with lingerie on, walking around serving food and drinks and everything. So it's going to be real nice and sexy.
I like this.
I love it. I'm going to be painted.
I make sure you get a business card and everything.
You want to be a vendor.
And I'm going to put together, then we also going to do, we have set a date for the Kidney Foundation fundraiser, the relaunch of it.
Okay.
We're going to do that June 20th, correct?
20th, yes.
June 20th, the week after the Ladies Pamper Party. Okay. So we're going to have a venue and everything for that when I get back from Michigan next week dealing with a family issue. We're going to have the venue locked down. Bigger and better this time.
Okay.
And we're excited about it. Of course, we're going to have you there, Ms. Wanda D, motivational
queen.
And so that's going to be going on. We just got a lot going on. I'm shaking and grinding. My calendar is filling up.
And
you know,
then too, I know that you can, people can also book their own personal.
Book your own private personal parties. Yes, you can. Like if
so,
fellas,
everything that you talked about, you can bring it.
Bring it to your
there.
Home. Mm-hmm. Bring it to your platform, no matter where you at. Chef does travel for that right amount. It's about that check. It's about that check. I would travel to California, New York, or wherever you want me to go. Long as them dollar signs is right, I will come to you with no problem. Very professional, very classy. I will come to your house. Please have a clean house, though, first and foremost.
Because I you have to send Lakeisha out to do an inspection.
We got to, my inspection. Pre-inspection.
She'd be like, oh, no, you're not going there.
Got to have a gas stove. If you don't have a gas stove, I can work with it, but I prefer a gas stove in your home. It makes it easier. But I do have equipment that I can bring, but I prefer you have a gas stove in home.
Okay.
And so, I will leave it clean just like, if it's clean when I get there, I'm going to leave it clean when I leave it, when I leave.
If it's dirty when you get there?
If it's dirty, that's an extra charging fee. We're going to charge at least a $300 cleaning fee.
Oh, my.
Can't cook in no dirty kitchen. Who does that? So that's disgusting.
Y'all got to get it right. So, Chef, put those gloves on and fix us up.
Since I got my blue gloves taken away from me and everything, you know.
Don't worry about it.
I'm going to go buy me some black gloves, you know.
You can do whatever you want to. But your hands was looking.
They were looking invisible on the camera.
Well, you know, it was just making everything bad.
Okay. Well, I like to keep it on the process.
Don't worry about that. Because all we want to do is
eat anyway. Okay. Yes. So this is my sun-dried tomato pesto.
Okay.
I got to make some without the tomato. So
for special people.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Smells herby.
Herby.
Yes.
Yeah, it's good. It's good. So you know what? So y'all carry on with yourselves.
Yeah, she finna come over and jump in the kitchen where she always likes to come at.
She always going in the kitchen.
Hey, Karen.
Hey.
She over there talking to the rest of the audience.
Karen.
What's up?
Have you been enjoying the show so far?
I
good to see you, Karen.
We missing some wine. I should have bought some wine today.
Yes.
So wine would have looked good with this.
I know, right? The rum punch sounds better. You look amazing. Yes.
What do you have up these days?
Oh, I'm still excited about my future.
Your future?
Mm-hmm. You been making movies yet?
That's in the future, definitely.
Okay. So yeah, I know Karen is a videographer. Her nickname is Video Lady.
Hey, Video Lady.
Video Lady. And then she tried to change that name on me. I never stopped calling her Video Lady. She was like, I'm just going to be, what'd you try to change that name to, back to?
It is still the Video Lady, and it's going to stay that. I'm going forward with it. But you can find me on Instagram as New Roads
there
Lady.
There she go.
Hey.
New Roads Lady. New Roads
Lady? Okay, so you changed it. Used to be New Roads Video. The company. Okay.
That sounds like almost new a porn Rose name for a minute. Lady. New race.
So, are you going to come to this naked porn party?
I think I'll pass that one.
It's an art. She is so silly, guys. She said knock, porn. Knock.
This is an erotic art.
Okay, erotic art party.
And if I can, I'm also looking for some artists that does painting and stuff. They can come and sell some of their artwork.
But what about, are we going to do like some poetry?
Yeah, it's going to be a full night of poetry. You know, everything that's dealing with art and music. You know, so it's going to be fun. I'm looking forward to it, you know.
Okay. So that looks good, Chef. So you got the prosciutto.
Prosciutto.
What's prosciutto? Is that like a ham?
Yeah, it's a very expensive ham. Because I got a pound of it here. Mm-hmm. And I got it from the Decatur Farmer's Market. Mm-hmm. And just this pound was $20 for some meat.
Meat costs.
All types of meat costs.
In all types of different ways.
Yes, it does. Yeah. So we got to get a picture of this. I'll be forgetting to take it, to get a picture of this so I can.
Well, you know, you got to get a picture. And we'll get a picture. So you're stacking it. So he has the layer of the tomato pesto.
Uh-huh.
And then
the prosciutto.
Then the prosciutto.
And then the mozzarella ball.
And then the mozzarella ball. Yum. Can y'all say yum?
Yum.
Yum. Yum.
Can we hear it?
Yum.
All right then.
You know Shimmy will be getting on the people, don't
you?
Gotta make sure we
She made sure that we heard.
We're a participating audience here.
So
well, Jeremy said, I hear you in there. You know, I'm keeping tabs on our social media hooked up.
So, you know what? Do a check-in. Who's on social media?
Me.
Okay. Because I know I'm not. I left my phone. I think it's in the car.
We have, of course, we have our own Mr. Jeremy.
Hey, Jeremy.
Okay. Hey, Jeremy. Jada Prince.
Yes, doing AKA in the house? Jada Prince. He's recovering, y'all.
Yeah,
We're gonna
put that hashtag pray for Jeremy.
Let me just pull this. They got it wrapped up. I got it cut so thin.
Mm-hmm.
This is what it looks like.
Who else?
Latasha Rose. She said hello.
This is what our prosciutto looks like.
Okay.
What did you say prosciutto was? Prosciutto is like an Italian ham. Yeah, and it's like you get it. I like to get it sliced. You can get it sliced thick or thin, but get it sliced thin. It's good for sandwiches.
Mm-hmm.
It's real good for sandwiches. It's a nice smoked meat.
So is it anything like Wagyu beef? Is it like bougie like that?
Yep, very bougie.
And Fitzgerald's very bougie.
I am.
Too much.
The bottom of it is a sun-dried tomato pesto.
Sun-dried tomato Shani pesto. Shani D. Shani D, what's in the house? Shani D, we miss you, Paul.
So
we miss
I'm you, making Shani. Without we miss the, without the, well, it's all, with without no meat, I got you.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you just want the sun-dried tomato pesto and the cheese.
Yeah.
I got you.
That'd be good. Yummy.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
We have Tracy Kincaid.
Yes. Hey, Tracy. Hey. What's going on? Tell them to put
in. That's hers.
Okay. Tell them to put in where they
This is the no pesto.
No
yes.
Pesto.
If you put in, please put in where you're watching
pesto.
From.
No pesto.
Pesto.
Pesto. Okay.
That's another vegetarian.
Okay.
Yep, Jeremy and Shani.
Pesto the full.
Talking it up.
Package.
What are they talking
Wait.
About?
This Ashley. Don't have any meat on it either. So no meat on that one.
No, it's meat on that one.
Meat on this one? Did I miss it? Oh, I got this little tiny piece.
Jeremy was talking about the guy who got the parental property.
Oh, yeah. I ain't knocking out.
We're going to keep that PG-13, but you'll see it later.
Yeah, but you have to be with that person, you know. I understand what you're saying, too, but I just can't. I don't have time to teach no grown person. And, you know, and me, the way I'm set up is you got to be all you got to be all where you're there. I don't got time to teach you. If I'm going to invest in and put in something investment in, you got to already have that mindset to that, you know, the value of what we're doing. If I give you some property, I expect for you to know what the value of that property is going to do.
I know you're jealous.
I just can't see myself doing that. You know, given it to, you know, you should be already educated as enough to know the value of things. You know, of course I'm going to help you and educate you on a few things, but at the same time, I ain't got time to educate you.
No, I totally understand what you're saying, but I've dated females who didn't understand the value of certain things in life as far as the gifts that I gave them, and just in giving them a basic conversation, they appreciated that, right? But I've also dated women who have given me things that I didn't know what the value of it was, and they educated me on those things because they were at a different financial level than I was. So all I'm saying is, you know, when I'm dealing with my people, I want them to understand. If they don't have an understanding of value, I'm going to show them so that they do. If not with me in the future.
Because I feel that if he knows how much of a Gucci watch costs.
Yes. Because he's been educated about Gucci watches. We have not been educated as a culture about understanding the value of owning anything. If you think about what goes on in America now, everything is leased or rented. Right. When you use Apple Music, you don't own any of that. Once you don't pay that monthly fee, that subscription, you don't own none of that. Right?
Exactly.
But 20 years ago, we had CDs, we had tapes that we owned the data and the information that was on there. Right? We have to, we can't, I don't feel like I'm going to throw away my people because we're not at the same place. I'm not going to do that.
I'm all with educating our people. I'm all for it. But, you know, that's where we had to take the time to educate ourselves, too, as well.
If you don't know how to educate yourself on certain things, how are you going to know to educate yourself?
Google. Pick up a book. We have – I take a note because we can go out here and find how much a pair of Jordans is. You can go out here and find out how much anything you want is. So there is no excuse to where we can't educate ourselves. I'm not letting you live that one down because it's our fault. We could go up here and look up how to go find a strip club. We can go look up how to educate ourselves. We have Google. There's books. There's ways of educating yourself. You can't be a dummy. If you be a dummy, that's your fault. Being a dummy.
Okay. I agree. All I'm saying is, wait.
We gonna tone down just a little bit. He.
Oh, seriously, we have to learn.
No, we definitely
read a book or something. We can find out anything we want to. We know how to book our plane tickets if we want to go somewhere.
Yeah, we have to.
There's no excuse.
And I agree with you, Chef. To some extent, there, you know what I'm saying? And well, to a high extent, we must learn to educate ourselves out here and make sure that we understand the different things that we have going on. You can hear the crunching in my, I'm sure you can hear it. Because people can't, that's what we want. You got that, you know, the SMR going on, you know, the good food going on.
Yeah.
So how you like it?
Well, I just, you know, like that, that's, like I said, that's a hot topic. And I'm glad that we have the different opinions because we definitely need to have the conversations. And it's no, I don't think there's a right or wrong answer to it because, like I said, I just would not have gotten such a big gift like that. But who knows? It just depends. I don't know what her bank account looked like. I mean, that might have not been nothing. Sure. Yeah.
So if you're dating an Oprah-esque, right, who's got money, or a Tyler Perry type, And his gift that the average American might think is a pair of shoes is a car, mm-hmm. right? Is he going to have to educate the woman on that car and the value of that car? Or is she already going to know that?
She's already going to know. Most women already know the value of anything.
So my point is, if they don't know the value of certain things just based off of what you get them and your value of it, how can you say that it's wrong for her to not know that? And then when I throw that, or not throw it away, but put it to the side versus what she values. That's all I'm saying.
I got lost.
Me too.
Okay. Here's my thought process on it. When we say we're teaching people the value of things, those things should happen prior to making big, giant purchases. I believe that when we want to teach somebody anything, just like we want to teach a child, we start from the beginning. Hey, look, let me see what your interests are. Let me see what you've been trying to do. It may have been something he had thought about. You know, we don't know. We don't want to, you know, make it negative. He just probably didn't want it at that time or wasn't expecting it at that time. But the education should have started first and before we started doing the big purchase. And she may not have seen it because it may have been an opportunity. We don't know. Like I said, we don't know her bank account. We don't know what opportunity popped up and she was like, I'm going to grab this right now because I know that's what he'd been wanting and, you know, he'd been talking about it and everything else and we're just going to go ahead and get it and we're going to go ahead and get it and it should make him really excited because ladies, me being a woman myself, ladies love to pay attention to what their men desire and their ambitions and their goals. Even if they're not there yet, we're already 10 steps ahead. We're already planning the banquets. We're already buying the properties in our head. So that might have just been what happened. And it might have just bombarded him because he wasn't ready for it yet. Or he was like, oh, dang, you got that. And, you know, like I said, we don't know how far into the process he was into it. But for women, we always, what I'm going to say most. For most women, when we pay attention to our man, we paying attention to the growth. We're seeing the building blocks.
Well, as should a man, too. I know I pay attention to the woman who I invest my time with. Oh. Because, I, you know, I want somebody that's just, because I know how I am. Because me and Lakeisha talk about this all the time. We're both entrepreneurs. And to date an entrepreneur, you have to understand an entrepreneur. Okay. We just can't see ourselves being with anybody because a lot of our time is spent hustling, building our business. And if you can't understand that, then we can't be with you. Because our mindsets are somewhere totally different. These are for her with the notes.
Yeah, Chef, you would educate that first.
Yeah.
Prior to doing like
asking anything, asking me of going out and just doing,
and I agree, the opportunity just popped up and it was like, okay, the opportunity is here, and we're gonna go forward with it. I'm not saying what you're saying is not incorrect. Yes, education, you know, educate.
Because education is the key, no matter what. Education. It is the key.
Communication, too.
Communication. And you got to know the person you're dating.
You need to know the person that you're dating. I'm not saying that she shouldn't have done it or this, that, and the third. Because, like I said, women love to pay attention to what their man's desires are and things of that nature. This may have been a desire. It may have been a long-term goal or something like that. So, in that hindsight, she might have been like, oh, wow, I got this property opportunity. I'm going to take it.
So, let me ask you a quick question. So, 2 or 3 years ago, did black folks know what Balenciagas were? Balenciaga, the designer. Balenciaga.
I knew what
Four
it was.
4 or 5 years ago, the mass majority of folks didn't know what Balenciaga were. Just like 10, 15 years ago, black folks didn't know what the red bottoms were.
And a lot of black people don't know about
the red bottoms because the celebrities were wearing them.
Like the Maury shoes or Belvedere shoes.
Okay. Right, but my point is, if you are in that lifestyle where your everyday purchase is a Balenciaga or red bottoms, and you date a girl who doesn't have a clue about either one of those things, right? And you bring her into that fold and you start showing her that lifestyle, right? Is it your job to educate her?
But that's different, though. That's materialistic stuff.
The same.
Because it is. Because most black. Because the value of like us, you know what I'm saying? We don't have multi-million dollars to go out and buy red bottoms. So we're not, first, we think about that. So that's why it's the furthest from our mind.
Okay.
Until we start seeing it, you write on these rap videos, these rappers start talking about it because they're spending the $1 million on doing it.
Never
just like with any types of liquor. Right. They don't understand no liquor until they see it on the rap
it's
video.
It's popular until people start rapping about it.
Exactly.
Okay.
So that's the mindset of that.
Okay,
well,
that's
my point, though.
But the mindset, okay, don't forget to put that. But the mindset is, you know, those type of things are what we're talking about. Those are the trending things that I was talking about.
Exactly.
If it's not trending,
then it's not being talked
not
about.
It's not going to be talked about. You know what I'm saying? So if you're a realtor, right?
Yeah.
So you sell houses. You know a lot about houses.
I know about houses. Right.
Exactly. You do. But you're dating a girl who don't know the inside of a house. You are going to walk her through the process. You're going to tell her about the things. You're going to educate her prior to her buying a house.
Prior to her buying a house. But if I buy it for her as a gift.
You would have already have talked about that house about 4, 5, 6 times. You'd have told her about how investments work. You told her about everything that she needed to know about a house. And then in your mind, because you know that she wanted it, you made the gift happen. Her, however, and when, like I said, I'm not going to judge because I don't know what conversations they had. The conversation might have been, baby, I want to own some property. You know what I'm saying? I want to be Jay-Z because everybody knows Jay-Z bought property. He brought paintings.
He bought art.
He bought all kinds of things. I want to be us. We want to be Jay-Z and Beyonce. Blah, 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 blah. And this, that, and the third. And in her mind, she's
I want to live the Nipsey Hussle, Lauren live life.
Right. Okay. So you want to be there.
Without a wheel.
Okay. Right.
So
we want, you know what I'm saying? Okay, we want to be there. So in her mind, she's like, now I need to go look into what I need to do. I got to find out what I'm going to bring to the table on this and everything else. Boom.
We as black people have to be careful who we idolize.
A property pops up.
Absolutely.
She's like, this is the time. This is the moment. I'm going to get this because he's going to flip when he sees it. However, the talk wasn't probably as intentional as she might have seen it at the time, and his wants weren't, you know, it was more or less a want superficially instead of actually, you know, in reality. And that's something that we do. We'll be like, man, you know what, the only thing they manifest is what they really, really want. They be like, oh man, tomorrow I'm buying the Jordans. They standing in line for 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 sleeping in sleeping bags on the side of the road waiting for these Jordans. Oh, tomorrow, oh, I'm going to get this whip. The intention may not have, she may not have heard the actual intent of it. But if she knew something about it, she definitely should have talked about it.
Wow, you know what? Okay, so how is that?
That advertiser off the hook.
Okay.
He put his foot in it.
Oh, that's awesome.
So,
go good that run punch. Right, I wish we would have had.
I'm going to get that in a second.
And if y'all want some more, I got some.
I want some more, yes. I want more, okay, yes. So whatever you got. More.
So, oh, yeah, we like to take
so keep in mind, guys, that you can hire Chef to come and do your
this is good
event.
It's awesome.
And as you can see, that just takes what you need.
We going with you after we leave so you can get us some rum punch.
So.
After the party.
So this,
this is a vegetarian one for the young lady.
Okay.
You good?
So,
thank you.
What we I guess we all can agree that, you know, we can agree to disagree. That's right. You know, and
a healthy
and
conversation.
That's the good thing about it, because like I said, there's no absolutely right answer. And like we had said before, if you're in a space of doing things that may seem a little bit abnormal to some, and then it might be normal to you. So it could be nothing for you to pull up and put out like that.
Shoni says, absolutely never standing in the line for shoes.
Right.
I hear you, boo. So,
you know, it's just a matter of doing whatever your heart's desire is,
that's true.
Whatever that looks like for you. But once you get on Facebook, man, you didn't put yourself out there. See, that's the whole thing. Don't be don't run from the critique. If you keep it private, you won't have to be critiqued. But if you open yourself up, then everybody's gonna have an opinion. And as my granny said, opinion is like a-holes. Everybody got one.
Everyone got one.
Because now what's the big talk now? The taxes now. Everybody in
their taxes.
Yeah. Who got their taxes?
Got their taxes.
I wish I did get some tax money back. Lord
Wanda,
Jesus.
Can I ask you a question?
Yes, I might not answer though. But go ahead. Shoot your best shot.
So you don't think that as a real estate professional, mm-hmm. that those who aren't educated in it, we're obligated to educate them in that?
This is one without the prosciutto. So I do believe that we have, without the prosciutto. So I do believe that we have I do believe that we have a responsibility as a realtor, because it's more so, and this goes with in any field. Uh-huh. If you truly are about what you do and your goal is to help people, no matter what area, whatever your area of expertise is, you should be wanting to educate. Mm-hmm. And not every time... And people sometimes, you know, it takes a minute for that light bulb to go off. So you have to, you know, do the whole repetition. That's why we can't just, you know, do things one time and expect for it to be done. You know, you mm-hmm. have to keep talking about it. I mean, you have children, so, you know, you
have one son.
Give me 15 right. Now. Okay, I'm not going to give you 15, but you have a child, yes. and you know, you can't just say, child, do that, and right. they get it the first time. You know, you have to keep on explaining to them.
Yes.
So... I do agree, and I really feel like we as black folks, we are very misinformed and miseducated. And although we do have Google, you're only going to Google what's interest mm-hmm. to you. So we have to say, and then too, the whole frustration comes with, even when you try to educate, we could put on an event and say free home buyers workshop or free informational workshop, and you get 3 people there. So it's still this barrier of understanding. People like to be entertained and liquored up
and free food
and free stuff, you know, they love free stuff. And even in the real estate world, when I was full-time agent in the office, the only way we would let somebody come and talk to us is if they was going to buy us lunch.
Oh, yes, that's true.
And that's the same in the pharmaceutical world, too. If pharmacists come in and want to sell new drugs to doctors' offices and stuff, they got to buy them lunch or something like that. They got to take them out,
bring something to the table. You know, and even though what you were going to be presented with was going to help your business or was going to help your health or whatever, you still was like saying, oh, but right now, I need to eat. You know, I know that it's going to save my life down the road. And yes. I guess, you know, so... where it comes to using our education, and this is where it really gets tricky, because a lot of people get frustrated by people not grabbing the information, and then they're frustrated. But as a professional, you can't get frustrated. You just got to keep doing what you do, right. And the ones that you're going to help, you're going to help them.
They have to have it. They have to have a open desire to be educated.
Absolutely.
Right?
Like one of my mentors always says, he said, everybody's not going to want to go with you. Right. You can't take everybody with you to the well.
You can't take everybody with you.
Yeah, you know, only a certain group of people are going to grasp, like you said, the information of everything, and that, you know, and they're going to run with you. Everybody's not going to run a marathon with you. Some are going to sit back like, well, this is not for me, and I can't do this. Or they're going to make an excuse for something. And then when they see y'all doing it, like, oh, man, I should have stuck with it. They over making money doing that. Why didn't I stick with it? Well, that's your fault.
Mm-hmm. Well, I see a lot of, you know, like what I said when I was talking about it, it's who's doing it too. You could be doing it. I could write a book. You wrote a book. I wrote a book. And then someone else who was higher and famous wrote a book. And our books are awesome. You know, they're great. But you'd rather stay with who's already famous. It's the same thing with advice. You could give advice. I can give it. All of us in here could give advice. let that same advice come from somebody famous, and all of a sudden they'd be like, they
heard it for the first time.
Oh, my
time.
God, they heard it for
That's
the first
like
time.
That's like with your kids. You're trying to educate your kids, and your kids go out in the street, and they hear something. I never forget when my son came home and said, yeah, Mom, I met this man. He told me I should be doing this, doing that. I was like, I looked at him like, really?
Did I just say that 2 weeks ago?
Really? Haven't I been saying that, like, all your life? You know, but it takes. It's like sometimes Jesus, you get no respect in your own hometown.
You sure don't. So, and sometimes it take the outside force to say that, you know, you be like, oh, well, did you get the message? Is that what I want to know? Did you get it? Did you get it? Because a lot of y'all don't get the message. It'd be like, okay, did you hear it? Because I told you 9, 6, 7. Okay, the famous person said it. You got it now? Okay, I hope you do something.
It's the same thing with your family not investing in your business. It goes the same route when it comes from the outside world. You know, they were the see. We can all have the same business or whatever. You can be a real estate agent, and your brother, cousin, sister, whoever knows about it. They rather go deal with somebody else than versus deal with you, because they don't want to give you the money.
That's
dumb
right.
as shit. Yeah. Excuse me, but that's how it goes.
And they have an excuse why they won't want to give you that money neither.
Right? Yeah.
Everything but what the reality is.
But they'd rather give them the same amount of money that you were going to probably make to the next person, which is mm-hmm. so retarded.
Yeah. But see, like I said, we talked about that before, and another thing, people are not going to follow your dream until you get there. It's like somebody don't want to be on your bandwagon until you fall off. And I already told people, I'm like, look, the bandwagon is gone. The train is set. Next thing I know, I'm going to be on the jet and I'm flying off.
Over.
I'm not going to be able to pick you up.
Right. So what I want to do is, Lakeisha, who got the mic? Fitzgerald, you hold on to it.
Okay.
So tell them how to get in contact with you on in your business and
so
how to reach you on Fitzgerald.
So my name is A. Fitzgerald Breland. I have a master's degree, so it's A. Fitzgerald Breland MBA. Everything is Breland's Universe, social media, LinkedIn, YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, type in Breland's Universe, and I'm there.
Okay, awesome.
Hi, everyone. I forgot to say it's a children's book series, so get it for your little ones, like 3 to 8 years old. And you can find me on Facebook. My name is Nicole Adams on Facebook. It's Adams6525 on Instagram. And also, both the books are available on Amazon right now.
Awesome. Fabulous. Children's books. I love it. Miss Lakeisha.
You guys can reach me on Facebook and Instagram, Designer Events by Lakeisha, and Twitter, Design Plan for You.
Design Plan for You. All right. So we got some stuff coming up. I did have one more subject.
Okay.
I would be remiss if I... Why Harvey didn't get the same treatment Bill Cosby got? I won't ask for that to be answered.
Oh Lord Jesus!
You already know that's gonna open up a can.
Oh my goodness!
Come on!
You
know. Going to the whole thing.
They said Harvey got raped in the third degree. So really nothing.
Nothing.
Even more subject. But, why did Trump intervene on his boy about the? He got mad at the Department of Justice because they was going to give him 9 years. Go figure, white justice,
white rules. Okay, well, anyway, that was on my list. So
I had one thing to say.
I got one more thing.
I do too.
Go ahead, you first.
All right, so, you know, everybody knows that we had a leap year this year.
Mm-hmm.
And so I had seen an article where a lady officially turned 21. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, the leap year, so she officially turned 21.
I don't get it. I'm slow.
Okay, so she's
she had a birthday
she
in 4 years.
She birthday in a
every birthday
is
February
29th.
Sorry,
she doesn't have a birthday every year. So her birthday is February 29th. When it's non leap years, she doesn't officially have a birthday.
Yes.
Wow.
So does that mean? That
so I get.
It does happen to add those years
no.
on?
I don't know, but I mean, I guess she celebrates February 28th or March 1st, but it's never officially her birthday. Her birthday was February 29th.
Yes.
It's every 7 years.
So she finally turned 21 and she had her first legal drink. Yeah. It was so
she's
cute. They had a cake.
Older.
And she was born in 1960. Like, look.
19, yeah, 19, she's an older lady.
Yeah, she's older, all right.
She's an older lady. Yeah, she was an older,
yeah.
She was an older Caucasian
but she didn't
lady.
Have an official
but she year. Didn't have an official birthday until
it was just
today.
So cute how they did everything.
It was yeah. cute because, like, this liquor store, the little the place, they gave her a cake and everything, told her happy 21st birthday. She's the oldest 21-year-old. It's cute.
That is so cute.
Wow. And also, I won't even go into that. That's a little bit too much. Y'all too fired up for me. I'm
hey, it's
freestyle Saturday.
We got Mr. Rum Punch over there, got us geeked up and everything.
Ain't nobody else geeked up. That's the problem.
The geek it is.
You know? He didn't want to share the.
I'll be geeked up all night long. What's up?
He's so silly. No. Okay, what were you saying?
Can I ask you one question, Wanda?
Yes.
So, in the comment that we talked about when we talked about dating and buying people real estate, can I promote buying people real estate when they're dating? That's a good thing for us in business.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
Okay, all right. When you're dating somebody and you like them, buy them a house and come through me, Breenland's Universe, all day long.
Okay, there you go. There you go. We plugged. We're not going to say what they can't do. I just said, you know, what I said. So that's all I got to say about that.
That's all we're
And when y'all
say
buy that house, you need a chef, hot call me.
Because you're going to need a house
and
a party.
That's right.
Together. And if you want to put together the right way, then call Lakeisha. She'll put it together.
And if you need a radio media host, call Wanda.
So we don't care how you buy the houses, buy the houses and know what to do. After you buy the house. That's all you got to do. So we got some events coming up, and I'm going to wait till our slides come up there, and then I'm going to get into talking about these events that we have coming up. So we got Study Hall coming up, and Study Hall is a play put on by teens. It's called Getting to the Root. It's attacking the bullying issue. So we want to raise the awareness to bullying. And this event is April the 18th, and it's going to be at the Results Central. Now, it kicks off actually on the 17th, which is the official Teens Against Bullying Day, April the 17th. So for those of you that want to participate, just go to Eventbrite. You can look up either Study Hall or and all of the things associated with that will come up. So if you want to come out to against the Teens Against Bullying over there at the state capitol in Georgia, it'll be great. We're going to meet with the kids and whoever else want to come do a tour and also have lunch. And that's what we have going on. This is a Why I Care production. And it's gonna be lovely. We have the Winning Evening News. That's another platform that we have where what I do is I interview entrepreneurs about their business, and it's three of us, me, Janelle Harris, and Jeremy Johnson. Which what I want to do is just extend my hand enough to entrepreneurs and letting them share their voice and what they're doing and how they're making a difference. So this is going really well. We started this about 3 months, four months ago. I don't know. Time goes so fast. But we do it every Wednesday. This is the Winning Evening News, and it's sponsored by the Wake Up Winning for Entrepreneur team. So we are the ones that sponsor that. So you guys, if you're interested in being a part of it, just send an email to the Winning Evening News at gmail.com. And of course, you know, you can join us every first and third Sunday right here inside of Status Network on Manifest TV, the I Am Enough talk show with the Motivational Queen and Chimia and Chef.
What up, though?
What up, though? So that's Jeremy Johnson, and I thought we were going to listen to, we are going to listen to his music. We have an event. Well, is there anything else? Yeah, there was. Was that it?
You talked about the teens against bullying. Teens Against Bullying, you talked about that.
This Friday. The meet and greet.
Oh, yeah.
We're doing the meet and greet this Friday.
That is, we're already in March.
We're in March. It's March 1st.
Oh, my God. Yeah. It's going to fly by like 2019 did. It's going to be a whole, it's going to be 2021 before we even know it.
Right. I know,
Jesus
right?
Christ.
So we're doing this meet and greet, and this is a great networking opportunity. Breland will be out of the country probably, but we're going to be at the Atlanta Crown Plaza Hotel over there on the airport one. And Noah MacArthur is a financial strategist. He's coming in. He said that there's some things that we definitely need to know because this is the new decade, and there's new financing opportunities that we need to be aware of. So he's coming into town, and we're going to talk about that. And so we're just doing a simple meet and greet. I'll be talking about media marketing and branding. And if you all come out and there's a need to extend the conversation to Saturday, we're going to be open to do one-on-ones. But Fridays is just going to be where we're going to just kind of do a little kickback and, you know, just a little
educate one another.
And yeah, just meet up, you know, and shoot your shot and, you know, work on building relationships.
Shoot your shot.
I came with y'all. Y'all all seem like y'all had rum punch.
Yeah, we just so high on life.
Just high on life. So
it's
so
the first of the month.
Wake up.
It's the first of the month.
So we're going to take a little break and play. I don't know, producer, we got the music ready?
Bone Thugs and Harmony, first of the month.
No, we get kicked off. Let's play Jeremy. Let's play Jada Prince. Live Out Loud. That's our theme song for the wake up for the winning evening news too.
Awesome. All good.
You know, that's all we got is right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Okay, so we're going to listen to this, and then we're going to come right back.
Right. 1 minute you could be alive, next minute you're a corpse, buried 6 feet underground.
Yes, we love us some Jada Prince. Right, all we got is right now. And that's what we love. You got right now, everybody. You don't have nothing else. Now, today's show has been absolutely epic, as always. The energy and the vibration. Did everybody enjoy themselves tonight?
Yes, yes. Yes,
yes. That's what I want to hear. Oh, no, I know we can go louder than that. Did everyone enjoy themselves tonight?
Absolutely.
Bad. Okay, fabulous. And you know we love... Uh-oh. The cues. Okay, so you know we love talking about all our hot topics today. We hope you all enjoyed our hot topics today. And please like, comment in, you know what I'm saying, share. Make sure you share, you know what I'm saying, because we try to get all the information out there for everyone to know. And we love to entertain everyone on the I'm Enough Talk show.
Absolutely, absolutely. And y'all also can make sure that you send an email to iamenoughtalkshow@gmail.com. If you are interested in being a guest on the show or perhaps, coming in here, just hanging out with us. We'd love to have you in the studio as long as we can, you know, just keep not have any fights.
No fights.
No fighting. But we have a great time, and it's only because we believe in what we're doing, because we definitely believe that your dreams matter. And for further services and assistance, what I do is I help people kind of keep I hold you accountable. So we know that we can always have big dreams and goals, but they only manifest once we make a decision that we will not let anything get in the way and derail that program. And it seems like as an entrepreneur, the hardest fight is just to keep on track, especially when you have an outlet to perhaps, you know, bring something else in, and you say, well, you know, I could just put that down for a moment. But we know that it keeps causing us to reset, and we want to stop hitting that reset button and hit that completion button. So can the church say amen?
Amen.
All right, then. So until we meet again, we will be back here on the 3rd. It's our Women in Biz time, and we will have our Women in Biz here. They will be bringing on whatever they're going to be talking about. Lord only knows.
It's going to be hot again.
It'll be rowdy, and hottie. Of course, every 3rd Sunday is the Women in Biz, and we come to you live and in color.
Always.
Okay. So with that being said, we want to say good night. Ta-ta. We love you, and there is absolutely nothing that you can do about it. Bye for now.
We'll see you next time.
Peace, love, and blessings.